Next question is from Cat Ill Est. How do I fix an imbalance between my left and right lats?
Same way you would work on an imbalance with any right to left muscle, which is to place more emphasis on the weaker, smaller side. Now, here's the challenge with this. The challenge is, and I know because I ran into this too as a younger lifter, you're afraid you're going to slow down your gains because you're focusing on the weaker side. Mm. You're not. The bigger side isn't going to shrink to match the smaller side. It's just that you're going to get the smaller side to speed up a little bit. One way you can do this, and I remember Adam bringing this up on the podcast a long time ago as a physique competitor, this is something he had to focus heavily on because he was getting judged by his physique on stage, was to do unilateral exercises, so one arm or one-legged exercises, right? So in this case, it'd be one arm. And then allow the weaker side to dictate the weight and the reps.
Yeah.
So if I'm doing like a one-arm row or one-arm pull-down with perfect form, and the most I can do is 100 pounds for 12 reps with my weaker side, that's what I'm going to do with my stronger side. Even if I could do more than that with the stronger side, I'm going to stop there. So it's the weaker side that's dictating the sets and the reps. And then what will happen, and you'll find by doing it this way, is it actually catches up. It actually does catch up pretty quickly, to do it this way. So exercises?
Rows. You said lat. I mean, literally almost everything that you would do with both your hands, you could do by yourself. So a seated single arm row, a lat pull down single arm row, a dumbbell row, a hammer strength row. I mean, all those, there's tons of exercises that you can do. Almost anything that you could do with a barbell that you would do for your back, you could do with single arm with a dumbbell. And so this is a perfect time to make your routine be all unilateral for a while. And I had to do this for my shoulders. I had to do this for my chest. I had to do this for my biceps, all at different periods of my training career.
You just get avoided barbells.
Yeah, I just avoid it for a while. And it only took, I want to say 3 to 6 months. I can't remember. Each one was probably a little bit different. But just simply focusing all on unilateral, so one arm, one leg, like you said, at a time in your routine, getting rid of the barbell stuff for a while. Because this is a priority, right? I know you hear us talk on the show all the time about barbell exercise, barbell. But that's why there's always exceptions to the rule. Mm-hmm. Like if someone's asking me, you say you need to do barbell exercises all the time, but then you guys say to do dumbbell exercises and get rid of barbell exercises. Well, that's because this person right here, this is an example of this now takes over a priority of, what exercise technically would build the most muscle on their body. And it's more, let's get it balanced out. Then we can go back to those barbell movements.
Right. And also too, I think also about posture and what maybe a block in that process in terms of unlocking more potential for you to gain access to your lat. So what if like your chest, for instance, and your pecs are a bit tighter on your other side, and you really need to do the work of mobility and assessing where those deficiencies may lie, if there's any asymmetry or anything within your posture that you can realign in order for you now to then really be able to focus on gaining more connectivity towards the lat.